No, not at all. I mean, that has been the popular will ever since the, at least the 2014 Occupy movement. There was this huge uprising demanding transparency, participation, accountability, and inclusion of many people into the decisions that affect the whole society. So in a way, the current administration and our way of working with the people, it is entirely a product of how the civil society has already started rethinking itself. But admittedly, just as our president Tsai said before, we think democracy and we think clash between two different values. So now we're in a transition where democracy becomes a conversation between many diverse values. But it is not us leading the civil society. It is civil society already have this consensus and this expectation of the public service. But public service must change first to let people see that we're trusting the civil society now before civil society can regain trust to the administration.
You mean that democracy is something that you have to learn, it's not obvious for most of the people?
I think democracy as it was conducted by the Athenians using stone tablets is not the same as democracy conducted over paper. And it's not the same as democracy conducted over radio and television. And now the democracy over internet and the multimodal way of people listening to each other, not just listening to one radio station or one television station, even though we call them democracy, they're actually very different governing models. And so I think this is not obvious from people who are versed in the previous generations of democracy, how democracy in the internet age must work. And so because it's fundamentally different, I don't think anyone has a privilege in saying that we're well versed in internet-based democracy. For everyone, this is a new thing that we have to share together.
You mean that
expressing their idea has radically shortened from the multi-year period to just a week or a few days.
Two more questions.
Yes.
I know that you're traveling a lot. How do you feel when you see that the biggest, so-called biggest democracy in the world can't recognize Taiwanese democracy, which is actually one of the strongest democracies? The tools that Taiwan is using to improve the democracy?
Yeah, well, there is a global network, such as the Digital 7, previously Digital 5, was organized with an exclusive goal of sharing the process, the code, the procedure, everything that can be reused among all the different jurisdictions. So I think our generation, we value this international collaboration. We see Taiwan as, of course, one of the very good labs to try this new methods, but there are many others. There are Estonia, there are the Iceland people, there are people recently from New Zealand. They're trying to incorporate many of our thinking into their new cabinet and their process. In the UK, Jeremy Corbyn used this idea as his campaign platform and things like that. And just this June, we're going to New York to work with the civil society and public sovereignty to collaboratively introduce this model to New York City. And so I think this is not something that Taiwan can do alone. We need to work with all the different people on the global scale and to take their innovations and incorporate here and maybe amplify a little bit, but then the next jurisdiction will maybe make it more advanced. So I think there's an international collaboration framework, and it's actually one of the explicit goals of the Sustainable Development Goal. The 17th SDG exclusively said this kind of cross-sectoral, cross-national collaboration is really the only way to achieve the other SDG goals.
The Western world, the so-called democratic world, they don't want to Taiwan as one of the greatest democracies. So why do you work with this democracy who comes to recognize you?
No, I think everybody recognizes Taiwan as a world's one of the leading new democratic entities. When I was in the Open Government Partnership in Paris City, I spoke in Paris City Hall about our democratic conventions, and all the delegates to the Open Government Partnership, they're very welcoming. Our introduction and our innovations, I haven't seen any single OGP member that comes to me saying we don't recognize Taiwan as a democracy. I haven't heard anything like that, so I don't know where your question comes from, but from where I come from, I see all the different democratic countries and entities. They see Taiwan as very valuable in providing cross-sectoral models for the UK.
For a conclusion, if you have taken time, if you have to define the Taiwanese democracy, what would you say?
Well, in Taiwan, we're very new, so I would say we're a young democracy, and we're saying that we're a very open to innovation democracy, and I would use a kind of academic word to say that we're a recursive public. That is to say, we're a public that is not just a republic about representation, but a public that is recursive. That means that we're totally looking at the way democracy works. And there's many people in the civil society, in the private sector, in the public sector, working on new innovations, like the new referendum map, the e-petition platform, and other democratic inventions. For us, democracy is not something that's fixed